For anyone starting an online business, there is always one strategy and one tool I'm fast to recommend, something you need to do before you launch your business or even before you launch a big sale such as Black Friday and Cyber Monday. It is conversion rate optimization and using a product experience insights tool. These names might sound really big and complicated, but I'll explain to you simply how you can use these strategies to increase your sales and customers. I've literally had clients go from $100,000 in sales to $1 million in sales with this one strategy and tool. So in today's video, let's go over the strategy and the must-use tool to start using today. There is no shortage of great CRO tools and apps out there, but one of the OG tools and my go-to is called HotJar. It's specifically a product insights experience tool and not just a CRO tool, which basically means it's a tool to truly understand and empathize with your users to connect the dots between what's actually happening and why. So imagine being able to understand the minds of all your customers and website visitors and collating all that useful information into a single dashboard with insights and almost sort of like mind reading your customers. And that's what HotJar achieves. I remember using HotJar when I was working as a marketing manager and thinking to myself like, wow, you can literally see how every single person interacts with your site. I used HotJar for multinational companies, and let me tell you, even the biggest companies make the most common mistakes on their websites. And these mistakes, they cost them hundreds of thousands of dollars in sales. And those sales we were able to reap back by using HotJar. In fact, in my very first YouTube video back in 2018, I said that CRO was a big reason I boosted sales, because what I realized was that a lot of people were clicking on the sales banner at the top of my store, but it wasn't linking anywhere. And so when I updated that banner to link directly to the sale, conversions skyrocketed and hundreds of orders literally came through that single banner alone. And so these sales would have been totally missed if not for using a tool like HotJar. This, by the way, is a paid tool, but well worth the cost. I will leave a unique link to a 15-day free trial in the description box below. Just a heads up for transparency's sake as well. This is not an affiliate link, but I am proudly partnered with HotJar. So let's go over how you should use HotJar and then jump onto my screen to show you how to set it up correctly and how to uncover those hidden gems to increase your business's sales and customers. So let's talk about how HotJar works, and feel free to jump directly to the on-screen tutorial in the play bar below if you're feeling a little impatient, but I do highly recommend that you actually understand how HotJar works so you can get more out of this tool. The simplest way to explain how HotJar works and how you should use it is by breaking it down into three different layers. These different layers include, firstly, the website, then the customer behavior, and then testing. So with the website, you need to understand how users are actually using your website, right? So without knowing this very deeply, you don't know how to improve the experience for your customers. And this includes things like, how long are people staying on your website? Are people quitting your website immediately on the first page? How often they're returning back, and those sorts of things. That's the website layer of using this tool. Then you have customer behavior. This is when we have to gather data about how visitors use your website and why they behave in a certain way on your website. You know, sometimes there's times when I look at these recordings and I'm like, why did this person jump out at that specific point in time? Well, we need to understand that. And that includes things like why they're abandoning their shopping carts, how they're navigating your website. Are they able to find what they need? And then finally, the final layer is testing. And once you understand what's going on with your website and your customers, you need to test changes and analyze how customers are interacting with these new changes. This could be placing things like the buy button somewhere else in a different color. And that's a small example. This is when you'll start to see increased sales and profit come through as you begin to test. And then some of the amazing HotJar tools we'll use to find valuable insights include heat maps, which show you exactly where the average user clicks, moves, and scrolls. And then we have screen recordings, live playbacks of exactly how users interact with your website. This is one of my personal favorite tools to discover hidden gems. And then you have surveys and feedback tools. You know, when you get that small pop-up on your screen asking how your website experience is, those are also CRO tools, product insight tools that help you understand what users really think about your site with incoming feedback. So all these tools add up to give you a crystal clear picture of what you can improve on your website and store. So the first thing you wanna do is get your free trial in the description link down below. So of course you have the free plan and the plus plan and the business plan. Most of you will probably go for the plus and business plan. They make the most sense. The major differences are the number of daily sessions that you get to record. So this is really important. So if you have more than 100 daily sessions per store, then what's gonna suit you best is the business plan. But if you're a brand new store, for example, then probably the plus plan works for you just fine. The other things that you get is rage clicks that you get to monitor with a business plan, which is pretty hilarious. It's when people literally get really annoyed and they start slamming the mouse. You're able to see that. You're able to remove the Hotjar branding and you get a few more customization integrations. So beyond that, plus and business are probably gonna suit you best. Once you have your plan or your free trial, you're going to install Hotjar onto your site because it's basically a custom piece of code that allows it to track your website. Most of you will be on Shopify. Some of you will be on websites, traditional websites. So with Shopify, the best approach to take is to install this piece of code yourself manually on the back end of Shopify, being the liquid coding part of Shopify. So I'll link a article, as you can see on screen here, in the description box below, and just follow this step by step. And just be really careful though, because whenever you play around with your liquid back end, even if you make a small mistake or a small typo, it can take down your Shopify store. So just be very careful of that. If you completely do not have any experience with liquid coding, or you're just, you know, you're too anxious about managing the back end of your website, there are apps that you can use to add Hotjar onto your Shopify store. So let me show you. If you type in Hotjar on the app store here, you can see that there's Hotjar install, Hotjar one-click install, and Hotjar install. All of these work fine. And what you're gonna do is pull a code from Hotjar and insert it into this app. I recommend that you do go with a manual implementation here and the instructions here, but it's ultimately up to you. I'm gonna show you a quick way of installing this if you're on a more traditional website or off Shopify. So most of you will use Google Tag Manager if you're installing this onto a different website. So I'll show you how to do that exactly. So once you click Start Setup, you'll need to connect your Google account with Hotjar. So I'm gonna go ahead and connect it. And then it's gonna connect it with Google Tag Manager. If you don't already have a Google Tag Manager, it's completely free and easy to set up. Then you're gonna click select GTM account. I'm gonna click on my account and click the tag container. So we're going to connect it up to andrewethanzang.com today as an example. And I'm gonna click create and publish tag. Then once you get to this step, click verify installation. So this is just going to verify that you have correctly installed your tag. So I'm going to click verify installation again. Then it's gonna do a quick check on your website to ensure that it is indeed properly installed. And you can see right here that the installation is all successful. So now we have to wait for the data to come through, pull through. So what I'm gonna do is wait a couple days, see the data come through, then I'll go through some of these awesome tools with you. But with the power of editing, within the next few seconds, you'll be able to see all the data on my dashboard. So let's get started. Okay, so it's already been a couple days and we've got some data pulling through onto our dashboard. Got a new cup of Piccolo and we're ready to go. So let's get stuck into what's happened over the last couple days. So this is the dashboard here, as you can see. And I want to speed run through a few features of this dashboard, get you customized and show you what to expect when it comes to your new Hotjar dashboard. All right, so this is where you get all your trackable information on the dashboard, but going deeper into heat maps, the recordings, the incoming surveys on the left-hand side here. Let's take a look at the heat map first. So if we take a look at the heat map for my home page, so not a whole lot of traffic has come through just yet, but there's been enough traffic to come through to set up a heat map. Obviously, you want more recordings and less. That way you get more accurate data to come through, but it's already really interesting. So no brainer that a lot of people click on the home page. They click on resources. And if you scroll down here, you can see that people click on courses. This sort of data will show you what is going on with your different pages. And that is so incredibly important and powerful, because otherwise you're just sort of assuming, and you don't want to assume because it makes an ass out of you and me. But moving on to recordings now, this is, like I said, my favorite feature here. If you can see on the left-hand side here, there's even a rage clicked section. So this is when people get really annoyed and they try to click something specifically, or they're really pissed off with something. You can literally see that. Thankfully, no one's rage clicked on my website just yet. But going back to all users, like I said, you can filter by country, by date, by actions, etc., etc. So looking at maybe this one here, if I click play as an example, what it's going to do is load up the recording of this specific user. So we can see right now what they're doing. You know, you can skip the pauses if you like. You can see how they interact with the site. Moving on to incoming surveys and also detailed surveys, I'll show you an example. This is how we can collect feedback. So you can see this little icon here that pops out, right? You can implement this into your website for really quick responses on how people are enjoying your website. So if I click implement and just set this all up, what this will do is automatically activate this on my website. And no, you don't need additional coding or any other elements here. Automatically pops up and collates all the data as well. Same with surveys. Surveys is a bit more long form. So this is where you get to ask them specific questions. And usually what I find is there's less of a conversion rate for these surveys because obviously it takes more time, whereas these incoming feedback widgets, these are extremely useful. So now you know how the dashboard works and its features, let's skip back in time a little bit and I'll talk to you about the strategy I would use if I were you just starting out with Hotjar to properly collate all the data together and take the most take advantage of Hotjar altogether. So now we've got it all up and running. What do we even test first? There's so many things to test, right? And it's quite overwhelming since we have so many different tools at our disposal when it comes to Hotjar. So firstly, you want to get very specific with your changes first. There's honestly probably hundreds of things to change on your website. Even if it's a very well optimized website, there are always improvements to be made. And usually though, your gut instinct of what needs to be changed is probably the most important. So make a list of three main changes and goals you want to achieve first based on priority. Then use Hotjar's tools smartly. I say this because you can literally spend days looking at findings, especially if your site has a lot of traffic. So make sure you use smart filters for your recordings. For example, if your main audience is from the States, then filter the data to display US specific data. Then tag these recordings that you think are important to re-review, and also view recordings at a faster playback speed. These things will like drastically cut down the time to find those really useful insights that are going to make you hundreds, if not thousands of dollars. So essentially you want to use Hotjar to validate or disprove what your gut instinct tells you, then make changes based on data. So I want to give a big thank you again to the kind folks at Hotjar for partnering up on this video and providing that 15-day free trial, which you can get started with in the description box below. And if you got to the very end of this video, you're an absolute legend. Make sure you comment the code word insights and drop a like if you found the video useful. It's always appreciated. And as always, thank you for watching.